Hi, I'm Vanilla. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Ohm's law. The German physicist and mathematician Georg Simon Ohm found experimentally that there is a direct proportionality between the voltage applied across an element and the resultant electric current at a constant temperature. When Ohm published his work in 1827, it was opposed and criticized. Luckily, his work was accepted later during his lifetime. Later, Ohm's law became one of the most basic and widely used laws of electricity. Here, the constant of proportionality is the resistance R. Ohm was also honored after his death when his name was chosen as the unit of electrical resistance. Mathematically, Ohm's law is represented by the formula V is equal to IR. Using simple algebra, this formula could be used to find the current and resistance values too. The unit of voltage is volt and the current is ampere. In some books, voltage is represented using the letter E. E stands for electromotive force. You can use this triangle to remember Ohm's law. To find the formula for voltage, cover the letter V. The visible parameters will give the formula. Here we get I multiplied by R. Similarly, to find resistance, we have to cover the letter R. This gives V divided by I. To find the current, we have to cover the letter I. This gives V divided by R. To understand this Ohm's law, let's look at some examples. Let's take a battery of 5 volt and connect it across a resistor of 10 ohm. Now, can you find the current that flows through the circuit? Using Ohm's law, we can find the current value. I is V divided by R. We get the current value as 0.5 ampere. Let's make a simple modification to this circuit. We will add one more 5 volt battery in this circuit. Now what happens to the current value? Here we have an additional 5 volt battery connected in series. Therefore, the total voltage is 10 volt. Now the current I is 1 ampere. What happens when we add a 10 ohm resistor to this circuit? Since the resistors are connected in series, the resultant resistance value is 20 ohm. Now the current I is 0.5 ampere. In all these three cases, we found the current value using Ohm's law. We can also use an ammeter to find the current flowing through the circuit. The ammeter is connected in series with the circuit to measure the amount of current passing through it. The ammeter will show the same value as the current value that we calculated through Ohm's law. Ohm's law is applicable and valid for many materials. However, some materials do not support Ohm's law. Ohm's law is invalid for non-linear elements. In other words, non-linear elements like diodes and transistors do not support Ohm's law. That's all for today. Bye. See you in my next video.